Rogers, Port of Tennessee, Representative Gordon. You did vote out HR 3200. That's something. I don't know what the hell it is, but it's something you haven't read. I want to make a comment about the unions, the service employee international unions. There might be some of the members here tonight. I keep saying, promoting a public option. And I started thinking, why in the heck are they care about health insurance and a public option? They got some of the best benefits ever negotiated by man. So why would they want a public option? And then I started thinking more about it. So you know what? If they unionize all the healthcare workers, if government takes over the healthcare system, I can imagine the union bosses salivating over all the new union dues over the left.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
In the HR 3200, this thing is not really a bill. I read it. I don't know what it was, but I read something online that said HR 3200. The unions, they're represented on the Secretary's Advisory Committee on Health, Workforce, Evaluation, and Assessment. They get a seat at the table to look at and see how health care workers are distributing their health care. And here's what I'm scared of. Man, you said, let's go check out some other countries. Well, I did the checking out. I spent 4 years in England from 03 to 07. When I got over there, I said, how do I get a doctor? I said, call the national healthcare system. They said, what's your postcode? I told them, we'll assign you a doctor. 3 months later, I got a letter telling me what my one doctor's office I had available for me. Okay, you know who the third largest employer in the world is? The United Kingdom's national healthcare system. Only behind the Chinese Red Army and India's railway system. They have 1.3 million employees that work on their healthcare system. That's the future of our healthcare system if we pass any kind of healthcare government takeover. And I mean, they don't mean what they said. They just had a record increase of 59,000 new people on the payrolls in NHS. And their health secretary, John Reed, said he was delighted with the growth, but added that he was aware that more action was needed to tackle existing staff shortages. There's 617,000 doctors, nurses, scientists, and therapists, meaning there's over 700,000 who don't even give health care on the health care rolls in England. If I'm not mistaken, Medicare is a government-run health care system. Am I correct?
Yes.
And are some people in here probably happy about their Medicare system showing hands? Happy about that? Good service, right? Okay. Can you tell me what the total unfunded liability for Medicare, Medicaid, and Part D is within a $3-4 trillion margin?
It's too big, and that's the reason that we need to take action.
$89.3 trillion.
And you just made a good case for us trying to get the cost of health care down. Given you a number of things that I think that we need to do tonight, and I can be happy to go over them again, to make Medicare more efficient. We need to do that. We've got to get the cost of health care down in the country so that we can balance the budget and we can make health care affordable for all.